Welcome to TCEQ's video for completing the lead and copper rule monitoring form, TCEQ form 20683. In this video, we will cover how this form is organized and walk through how to complete each section. Form 20683 has two pages. The first page provides space to record information on lead and copper samples. The second page provides instructions for filling out this form and includes descriptions of what information is needed. In this video, we will walk through how to complete the first page. This form is available on the TCEQ Lead and Copper website. You can print out this form and complete it by hand or complete it electronically as a PDF before printing it to be signed. If you choose to complete this form electronically, please make sure you download it first, as errors can occur when completing this form in your internet browser. Additionally, please be aware that this form is for compliant samples only. Any samples submitted with this form will be reported to TCEQ for compliance. For non-compliant samples, please contact your lab for their relevant form. The first page of this form is organized into green and blue sections. The green section should be completed by the public water system or an agent working on their behalf. The blue section should be completed by the lab. You should only complete the section relevant to you. In this video, we will discuss how to complete both sections. Using the chapter feature, you can jump to the section relevant to you. Please be aware that when recording a time on this form, you are required to use the 24-hour format, i.e. military time. This means not using AM or PM. Failure to use this format may result in requests for corrections and delays in testing and data submission. If you are unfamiliar with the 24-hour format, please feel free to reference the chart on the right. First, we'll walk through how to complete the section for public water systems, the sections marked in green. This is what the front of Form 20683 looks like. Let's begin by filling out the PWS information. As we go along, an example of required information will appear on screen. In the PWS name section, write the name of your public water system. In the PWS ID section, write your 7-digit PWS ID. In the PWS address section, write the physical address of your public water system. In the PWS contact section, write the name of someone who can be reached if TCEQ or the lab has questions regarding the samples. In the PWS contact phone number section, write a phone number for the person listed as PWS contact in the line above. Next, let's go through the tap sample checklist. Mark whether your samples were filled to the 1-liter volume, whether they were collected from cold water taps, whether the sample containers have labels, whether the samples were taken from frequently used inside sinks, whether those sinks were unused for 6 hours prior to sample collection, and whether the samples were delivered to the lab within 14 days of collection. Please be aware that samples need to meet all of these criteria to be accepted by a lab, and samples that don't may be rejected. Additionally, please be aware that any lead and copper samples taken from entry points will have different collection procedures, and not all PWS TAP sample checklist items will apply. Please contact the Lead and Copper Monitoring Team for guidance if you have questions regarding entry point lead and copper sampling procedure. Next, let's fill out some information on our samples. In the first column, write the facility IDs for the samples. If a sample is from an entry point, the facility ID should begin with P, B, C, U, followed by the entry point number, which can be found on Drinking Water Watch under the Water System Facilities tab. If a sample is from the distribution system, then the facility ID should be DS01. In the second column, write the sample point IDs. If a sample is from an entry point, this sample point ID will be ELCR. If a sample is from the distribution system, the sample point ID will be the LCR number for that sample location. In the next column, write the addresses where the samples were collected. If a sample is from an entry point, this will be the address of that entry point. If a sample is from a distribution system site, this will be that site's address. In the next two columns, write the date and time that the sample faucet was last used. Note that you need to write the time using the 24-hour clock format shown on the form. In the next two columns, write the date and time that the samples were collected. Note that the time should be written using the 24-hour clock format shown on the form. You should only complete the last three columns for replacement samples. If a sample is a replacement sample, check the replacement indicator box, fill in the sample ID assigned to the sample needing replacement, and the date that the original sample was taken. Next, we'll complete the sample collection acknowledgement. This section certifies that the information included on this form is true and accurate, and that sampling sites were selected following the approved TCEQ Form 20467 and the PWS monitoring plan. To certify that the information on your form is true and correct, print your name, sign your name, write your organization's name, and fill in the date you are signing this form. TCEQ recommends that you print this form and sign it by hand. If you are interested in signing this form electronically, please contact the Lead and Copper Monitoring Team for our policy and procedure regarding electronic signatures. Finally, we'll fill out the chain of custody information. The chain of custody records who has had possession of your samples, and every time they change hands, you need to document who takes possession of your samples and when. For each transfer, you'll need to include the signature of the person relinquishing the samples, the signature of the person receiving the samples, and the date and time the samples were transferred. If samples are delivered directly to the lab, then only the relinquished by and received by lab sections need to be completed. If a courier is used, like in this example, then all four sections need to be completed. With that, we have completed the PWS assigned sections. Please double check what you've entered on this form to minimize delays in lab processing. Once you have done so, you are ready to submit this form along with your samples. Your receiving lab should complete the sections in blue. In the following part of this video, we will walk through how to complete these lab-specific sections. In this section, we will walk through the completion of the lab portion of the lead and copper rule monitoring form, the sections marked in blue. For the purposes of this walkthrough, an example of PWS information has been filled in already. First, let's complete the lab contact information. Start by filling in the name of your lab. Next, fill in your lab's TCEQ lab ID number. Your lab ID number starts with a T and is followed by the first 9 digits of your NELAB certificate number. Next, fill in your lab's address. Then, fill in the name of someone who will serve as your lab contact. Finally, fill in the phone number for your laboratory contact. Next, we'll record the conditions of the samples upon receipt. Mark whether the samples were delivered unpreserved, whether they were collected in 1-liter labeled containers, whether the samples were filled to the 1-liter volume, what the actual and corrected temperatures of the samples were, and finally, record the ID number of the thermometer used to measure the sample temperature. In the next section, we'll assign lab sample IDs and record additional information on the samples. In the first column, assign lab sample IDs using your lab sample ID assignment procedure. Please ensure that numbers remain unique. Duplicate sample IDs may cause errors with sample acceptance by TCEQ. If the samples were preserved by the lab, record the date and time they were preserved in the next two columns. Please record the time using a 24-hour format. Next, if the samples need to be rejected, put the applicable rejection code in the final column. Finally, fill in any additional comments you may have in the laboratory comments box. With this, we have completed the lead and copper rule monitoring form 20683. Please double check what you've entered on this form, and once you have, it is ready to be submitted to TCEQ. If you have any additional questions on completing this form, feel free to reach out to the TCEQ lead and copper monitoring team by phone at 512-239-4691 or by email at pwslcr@tceq.texas.gov.